This video is the first in a series on the economic and environmental cost of Bitcoin. We will be revisiting my work from 2014, there's a link to the report below, which had a look at the relative sustainability of Bitcoin compared to gold and the banking industry. We won't be revisited banking in this series, but we will revisit gold. Before we can get a good estimate of the economic and environmental costs of sustaining the network, we need to understand several underlying principles and concepts, namely, the relationship between capital E energy and lowercase e energy, and between capital B Bitcoin and lowercase b Bitcoin, Bitcoin macroeconomics, perfect competition and Bitcoin microeconomics, perfect competition and managerial economics, economic inputs and drivers in the running of the Bitcoin network, and environmental inputs and drivers in the running of the Bitcoin network. We will then demonstrate our model of calculating the cost of a Bitcoin. Then, as mentioned earlier, we'll have a very thorough look at gold versus Bitcoin, and finish off with a bit of discussion to put everything into perspective. If you want to skip ahead, you can read the full report, which contains all references and links and citations. I've included the link to the report in the description below. It's important to note that the data in the report is from the end of July 2018, and things can change very rapidly when it comes to the hash rate growth of the network and changes in mining technology and hardware prices, not to mention the market price of Bitcoin. We will also be releasing cited articles to accompany all videos in this series so that you can follow along each week. So, let's have a look at the relationship between Bitcoin and energy. To understand the nature of Bitcoin and its ties to energy, spelt with a lowercase e, one needs to understand the concept and nature of capital E energy. Energy is the prevailing force in the universe, both Father Time and Mother Nature. It cannot be created or destroyed, only transformed from one state to the other. It is the finite but infinitely divisible, shape-shifting soul ingredient of the universe. Its force cannot be stopped, only harnessed through its good graces. The Big Bang can be considered the birth of all energy and laws of nature, whereas Bitcoin's Big Bang was the codified creation of 21 million coins, of which 50 were discovered in the mining of the Genesis block. Since then, 17 million have been discovered, with the rest to be mined in a predictable manner over time. Energy is split infinitely into units of lowercase energy and mass, calories, pounds, joules, kilograms, etc. Just as capital B Bitcoin is infinitely split into units of lowercase b Bitcoin. No mass, just energy. From here, the link between energy and Bitcoin becomes evident when looking at nature and life and the economic evolution of humans. At the most primal level, the first instinct of life is to survive. Energy is life, and life is sustained by energy. Plants get their energy from photosynthesis. Predators do this by consuming more calories than they use to hunt their prey. Human civilization has evolved to the point where we can transform energy into a state of power, that is fire, steam, coal, nuclear, batteries, you name it. This has taken us from harnessing fire to cook food millennia ago to much more capable energy sources now. Thanks to all the energy we produce, humans now expend their calories in the pursuit of currency and money to purchase their food calories and other things required for survival, and to store the rest for future use. There are huge differences between currency and money. Money is finite, whereas currency is not, and therefore it can be compared to energy and retains its stored energy over time. When the gold standard was abandoned, our paper currency became backed by nothing but promises. Ever since then, the value of currency has tended to zero and money to infinity. Currency violates the rules of energy by being created out of nothing, aside from the comparatively infinitesimal energy used to print out currency and mint coins, that is. Disrespecting nature has led to dangerous levels of global wealth and income inequality and widespread social and economic suffering. No form of life has defied energy and survived in the long term, and this has been the case for billions of years. Cryptocurrency is the life of money, of which Bitcoin was first life, literally converting energy into money. It has evolved to keep meeting market needs and sprouted a thriving cryptocurrency ecosystem. Bitcoin was designed to last as long as humans do, wherever they are in the universe with a communications link. Obviously, in the distant future, if humans have stood in the face of energy and not harnessed it in a clean and renewable way, they will perish. Therefore, as we continue to advance technologically, the Bitcoin blockchain will be a permanent, emissionless store of monetary energy. money secured and proven to be both finite and earned through hard work, literally proof of work, using massive amounts of energy in the process. As always, thanks for watching, and don't forget to like this video and subscribe to this channel for more. You can also follow us on Twitter and LinkedIn. Until next time.